Welcome once again to the Hafjell Alpine Centre for continued coverage from the 2016 Lillehammer Winter Youth Olympic Games. I'm Simon Golding and I'll be with you for the whole of the ski cross event about to get underway in just a moment live here on YouTube. Well, the athletes started their competition with a qualification run. That qualification run is always skied on your own for a time. And with those fastest 16 athletes going through to the next round, or if there's only 16 in the competition, being seeded through to the next round in their various places. And unlike the World Cup, the competition will then go to a round-robin format as opposed to a straight knockout. And each athlete is going to race against all of the others across a series of 40 heats coming up this afternoon. 20 for the girls and 20 for the boys. And they'll collect points as they go. So four for a win, three for second, two for third, and one for fourth. And that will effectively then create us a league table. And from that league table, the top eight will go through to the semi-finals. And that's when things get really interesting. The knockout phase then comes in for a place from the semis onwards. And it's for a place in the medal final or the small final. And then we'll see those medals decided in around about 2 hours' time. Well, we're looking forward to a really fantastic afternoon of racing. We've already had the snowboard cross, and it's been a good day so far for France and the USA here in Hafjell, with Manon Petit and Jake Vedder picking up the gold medals in the snowboard cross for their countries respectively. Now, in terms of qualification, we've actually had some really fast times down this course. Clara Kasparova, the fastest of the girls at 45.48. She was just ahead of Ganton Bein of Switzerland and Zoe Chor of Canada. And those three will be joined by Zaley Orford to go in the first run. Confirmation then of those times that I was talking about. And that's quick. That is really quick down this course. Now, they were racing on their own in that qualification phase. So once you factor in another few people on the slope with you, that's when things can start to change up a little. You introduce those extra variables, those extra factors. That's how the ladies' event looks. In terms of the men, well, it was David Moberg of Sweden that was the fastest. And my goodness me, 42.86. Only two men going under the 43-second mark, and that was Moberg and Cornel Wren of Germany, who was just 0.05 off that time set by Moberg. And then a little bit of separation after that. But there's a few guys in there, the likes of Mullen and Crawford. When you move down through that list, they can certainly look after themselves out there, so they'll be looking to cope with the physicality of this particular event. Things can get very tight on those turns, but we're just about ready to go then with our opening heat. Remember, 20 for the girls, 20 for the boys. We're going to go four heats for the girls and then four heats for the boys, and we'll repeat that all the way down. Clara Kasparova in red, Ganton Bein in green, Chor in blue, Offord in yellow, the Australian. And remember, it is Kasparova that is quickest through from the qualification. Oh dear, and we've had a start gate failure first up. What a shame. And nobody happy about that. Least of all the athletes that felt they got off to the best of starts. Look at that. That's the kind of power being applied to the start gate facilities. And I think we're going to have a bit of a hold here while we get the repair done. The way it works with the start gate, you can't go early. So you can push up against it as hard as you want, but it essentially stops a full start. But what can happen is that you can destroy the equipment in the process. And as the clock ticked down to zero, left two athletes behind. I can tell you, that would have been heart in the mouth that moment there, if you were one of the athletes stuck in the gate. And you can see the fiberglass frontage there damaged, ripped away as they tried to push through with the skis, get the barrier to release. It was a demanding time, this, and a really good learning process for these teenagers. Trying to find out what top-level competition is about, and we're talking about world-class skiers here. Quite a few have had Europa Cup experience and will be progressing on to the World Cup circuit in not too long a time. This first heat, interestingly, involves the four fastest athletes from qualification. So, depending on what happens during the course of the racing this afternoon, it's entirely possible that this would be relatively close to the final that we may end up with. Depends how the seeding works out for the semi-finals. But certainly expect to see Kasparova and Gantenbein with those times in amongst it. Well, if you just joined us, men's and women's ski cross from the Winter Youth Olympic Games here in Lillehammer. About to get underway. Already had gold for France and for the USA in the snowball cross events. And a final check that everything is working. So fingers crossed, we're going to get our athletes away in the first heat of 40. Don't worry, those heats will fly by. Under a minute to get down the course, then providing we've had no fallers and no safety checks required on the barriers, we'll get straight into that second heat. So effectively we'll be running a heat every 2 minutes. So reminder, fastest qualifier, Klára Kasparová from the Czech Republic in red. Talina Gantenbein, second fastest qualifier from Switzerland in green. Zoe Chaw from Canada, third fastest qualifier in blue. And Zaylee Offord of Australia in the yellow, fourth fastest qualifier. So this is a high quality opening heat. Then this whole round robin process will play out and we'll be away. Good chance when we see this at race pace. Good chance to take a look at this course. It's not a monster, it's not a brute, so very skiable, but not a lot of opportunities to pass on this. So if you can get yourself a lead coming out through these initial rollers and tables, then you should have a good chance of really protecting that. Away we go then. This time the gate functions and Kasparova pumping the legs across the rollers and the table gets into that wonderful glide, aerodynamic race position. And the Czech Republic skier is away. Zaylee Offord, the physical racer, is Offord, doesn't mind mixing it up. Now, negative turn into the next jump and dealt with by all four racers comfortably. And remember, we're looking at the fastest four from qualification. We'll see exactly the same in the men's. Another negative turn for them to deal with. But no real push here in terms of taking Kasparova's top spot. Again, a little pump over the rollers to the finish line, and Kasparova crosses the line for 4 points. So she opens her account, and on this round-robin league format for the first part of the competition, you're trying to score as many points as you can to get into the top eight and book your place in the knockout semi-finals. So Kasparova takes the four. That's a good ski from Zaylee Offord, the Australian. She'll take that, 3 points for her. And Talina Gantenbein and Zoe Chaw dancing it out for 2 and 1 points respectively. So that all goes on to the league table as we move into our second heat. So heat two of the first round. Veronica Adebo in the red for Sweden. Dana Wolfk in the green for Russia. Celia Funkler of Germany was fastest briefly in qualification. She goes in blue. And then Martina Rainer of Austria, 16 years of age from Bischofshofen. One of the youngest athletes in this competition, Rainer. And cleanly, comfortably away through those rollers. And Adebo looked very strong there. We've just had a fabulous weekend of racing in Idrefjäll in Sweden, on the Ski Cross World Cup Tour. And one of Adebo's heroes, Sandra Naesland, successful. A couple of very good second places for her. And then Erling Nürburgring, another Swedish superstar in Ski Cross, getting the win on the Sunday. But this all looks very good here for one of the new stars of Swedish Ski Cross. to the line comfortably. Dips just to go through the whole race pace training situation, but Veronica Adebo picks up the 4 points. And that puts her joint top of the round robin leaderboard with Kasparova after that first race. Offord is level with Funkler. And then Reina picks up the 2 points. Vov picking up the single point for Russia. Top eight, remember, is the focus for these 16 athletes in the round robin. So second of the women's race is done. Into heat three. Jacqueline Nielsen of Denmark in the red. And Mia Leikkainen of Finland. Also had a decent qualification. And to complete that start list, Margot Tresal-Moros of France in yellow. Leikkainen is in green, Nielsen in red, and Abigail Zagnoli of USA in the blue. Comfortable at the moment for Tresal-Moros. You see how different things can be once you get into the race proper. Changes things a lot from that individual qualification for speed, but Nielsen getting back into it. Nielsen in the red bib, the fastest qualifier in this heat. That is really tight on the negative turn, and that is very aggressive from Nielsen, pushing Tresal-Moros out onto a line she didn't really fancy, and the Frenchwoman is having to work hard here. But this is going to be a four-pointer off a very, very tidy inside move from Nielsen. Sorry, Tresal-Moros not suffering, managing to, by the looks of it, stay in second place. But this is what ski cross is about. Through the negative turn, gets onto the inside line. There was a little bit of physicality there, but not too much pushing or arm waving. I don't think we'll get a review. That will stand. So confirmed by the sounds of it at the moment. There's some discussion there. Nielsen may be in a bit of trouble here. Well, we'll wait for confirmation. And it is Nielsen's 4 points at the moment. Doesn't look like the jury are going to say anything else. So Margot Tresal-Moros with the three. Abigail Zagnoli is making the complaint. She's not happy, but she's picked up the 2 points. So the league table's now starting to play out. Really top two position all the way through these heats if you want to keep yourself in good nick for a place in the semis. Magdalena Casas Cordero then of Chile in the red bib. Fastest qualifier in this heat, Isabel Brown of Great Britain. We've already had a gold medal for the British with Maddie Rowlands in the freestyle ski halfpipe yesterday. Fabulous performance from her. Let's see if Brown can get in amongst it today. Aizan Sapyanova of Kazakhstan in blue. And Ebba Rud of Norway on home snow in the yellow bib. Last of the heats then for the ladies in this group. And away to that first little set of rollers. Really have to keep the legs pumping there to get the timing off that last roller onto the table. That's exactly what Casas Cordero has done. And the Chilean, who turned 18 back in January, is leading this one comfortably at the moment from the Valle Nevado Ski Club, two-time Chilean champion. Also a really good alpine skier. So expect to see her going across a few disciplines in years to come, but ski cross at the moment is her focus. A little bit wide through that negative turn where we saw the great move from Nielsen in the last race. And gets into that racing tuck very comfortably. It's going to be the win for the Chilean. So she puts 4 points in the bag. Nicely done. First set of four races for the women at the heat stage comes to a conclusion. So Still waiting for confirmation of the result. Casas Cordero picks up the four. Sapienova of Kazakhstan got the 3 points. Rude of Norway got the two. So working out very nicely indeed for the Chilean. So that leaves the league table looking like this. We'll update it every four races for you as we go through. But for the moment, Kasparova, Edebo Nielsen and Casas Cordero are in good position with their wins in the opening heats. And now we move from the ladies' competition to the men's. Same as the ladies, first race up. It involves the four fastest qualifiers through to this stage. Evy Moberg of Sweden, courtesy of his quickest time, and I remind you it was very, very quick, sub 43 seconds, along with Cornel Wren of Germany in the green. They were the fastest qualifiers. And then Rhys Harden of Canada coming through with Zoe Chaw through a very tough qualification process over there in North America, but getting the call to represent Canada here at the Youth Olympics. And finally, from Australia, the Aussie rules loving Louis Mullen. Both he and Dougie Crawford, two Aussies who don't mind a bit of the physicality that comes along with the sport of Australian rules. That may put them in decent stead here. You're not allowed to dish it out, as it were, but you will get the occasional collision. Nothing you can do about that when you've got four bodies going down such a tight track. And if you can deal with the physical side of this sport, make the moves when you need to make them and cope with that, then you are going to be in a decent position come the finishing line. So red in green, Moberg opting for that inside gate in red. Howden in blue and Mullen in yellow. That was a big kick from Wren, trying to get some momentum off the last roller, and the Germans struggling here at the moment and having a little bit of afters with Louis Mullen, the Australian at the back of the pack. Through that negative turn where we're going to see a lot of action today. That was certainly action. A big push from Moberg sent Mullen out of it, and that's left the blue bib of Rhys Howden, the Canadian, to sit in top spot. So Howden benefiting there from that little bit of physical stuff on the way down, and it's going to be Howden that takes the 4 points, lunging for the line, punching through the timing beam. And Rhys will settle with that for an opener. Well, it's that negative turn just ahead of the big jump where we're going to see a lot of the physical stuff going on today, no doubt about it. But it's the 17-year-old from Washington State, from the Okanagan ski team, who picks up the 4 points. Moberg three, Wren taking the two, and Mullen shoved out of it, having to settle for the one. Next heat then for the men. We start to move down through the qualifiers that weren't quite as quick, but still fast enough. Xander Fagerman of Belgium in red. He's opted for the far side on this start. And Marcel Hilmaert in green. Sascha Rödi of Switzerland in blue. And Dougie Crawford in the yellow. Crawford, one of the only athletes not to cite a winter sports athlete as his hero. His sporting hero is Nate Fyfe, the Aussie rules player, Fremantle midfielder. See if we can put a bit of that combative strategy into it. Crawford leads then in the yellow. Look at that for a racing tuck, really getting the head down towards the knees there and trying to close this one out. That's our closest to a photo finish that we've had so far. I think it's probably Crawford's 4 points. But we will see. He was very good. A little bit wayward from Vikaman off a couple of the jumps. Went a bit high. How's that for a line from Crawford? And once he got there, kept the speed and dipped it for the line. That's a very good ski from him, and that's a very good finish as well from the Austrian, Marcel Hilmaert. I think he's just managed to get the photo for the 3 points. to have all of that confirmed in just a moment. And these points important here at the early stages. And it is. That is a great effort, but interesting from Vercammen. Didn't lunge for the line, just looked straight across at Sascha Ruedi of Switzerland. Not quite sure about his tactics there on the finish straight. I think Vercammen's going to have to be a little more focused than that. Well, the photo's being reviewed. That's why we are just on a race hold at the moment. Really important for these young athletes that we get everything right. And that the organisers and the jury give the points to the right people. So much on social media coming into this Olympic Games, this Youth Olympic Games. Athletes so excited about their opportunity to really show what they can do on the world stage. That's become a theme, hasn't it? The organisers and volunteers around the various venues these days joining in and motivating the crowd. And it is Dougie Crawford's four-pointer. Ilmaier 3, Ruedi 2. And Vercammen pays the price there for looking across at the rest. Finishing with just a single point. Next up then, Russell Marm of the USA. He can look after himself out there if he needs to. He is a fast man. And in the red bib, the fastest man in this heat as we get heat 3 underway. Just a reminder who we've got. Marm in red. Matteo Lucatelli of France in the green. Tobias Nolsason of Italy in the blue. And Roberto Negrin of Chile in the yellow. Chile already doing well in the women's event with his compatriot Magdalena Casas. Heavily placed with a four-pointer first up. But it looks like Lucatelli having it all his own way for France here. Malm just getting involved in a little bit of afters on that corner. And Lucatelli crossing the line. Very impressive. Only three finishing, unfortunately. But that is ski cross. Can't guarantee that we're going to start and finish with all four. Just looking through the bib list to see who it was, and it was Roberto Negrin that was already stumbling. So it looks like Negrin has gone down. Yes, it was him that went down. Lucatelli takes it then. With Marm and Nolsason just behind him. So a good starter for the young Frenchman. Negrin has to settle for the 1 point, but he'll be back to fight again. Lucatelli 4, Marm of the USA 3. Just out skiing Nolsason to the line. So heat 4 before we go back to the ladies' side of the draw. Well, getting this one underway, we've got Kirill Bagin in red, Mossad Harvey in green, Benz Nagy in blue. The Hungarian and Soto Herrera of Mexico, who bases himself over here in Europe to train. Soto Herrera is a decent racer. Again, one of these athletes that is multi-skilled, multi-talented. Skis across a whole range of disciplines, but it's Bossard Havi of Norway. It is comfortably in the lead at the moment, much to the delight of this crowd. With Soto Herrera in the yellow. Looks like he got the dip there on Nagy. I'm not sure the Hungarian realised that he was coming. And, we lost Kirill Bagin on the way down. Well, I told you Soto Herrera could ski. There goes Bagin coming out at that negative turn where I think we're going to see so many thrills and spills. It's a very tight turn. If you're going to get involved there, then you've got to set up for that next jump. Make it in between the gates, and that's not easy. So Bossahave with the 4 points, Soto Herrera with the 3. Nagy has to settle for the 2, and Bagin has to settle for the single point.
He'll get three more races to try and atone for that. Let's just check how that leaves us. Howden, Crawford, Lucatelli and Bosarhavi with those wins at the moment at the top of that tree. But it's top eight. That's what you're aiming for a place in the semi-finals. On we go then. Next round of ladies' heats, five through to eight. And Clara Kasparova once again involved in the red bib, fastest woman down this course so far to date. Veronica Edebo of Sweden in green, Nicole Nielsen in the blue, and Casas Cordero in the yellow. This is another cracking heat. Now watch out to see if Nielsen tries to pull that inside manoeuvre on the negative turn again. That's a good hard ski from Edebo though. Worked very hard over the rollers to get out of the hole shot into the course. And she has a good solid lead there to protect Kasparova. Oh no, Kasparova in trouble. Just took her eyes off the course and unfortunately came out on the big jump. She was looking at her next move, looking ahead, and just didn't take care of business. And the fastest qualifier, Kasparova, is out of this one. And let's hope that's not an injury that takes her out of the afternoon's racing. That's left Edebo with a clean run for the 4 points. And if she stays upright, it's hers. It is hers. And Nielsen taking the three. So that's another good score for Nielsen. And Casas Cordero taking the two to add to the one to the 4 points she picked up earlier on. Well, that's always a good sight to see the racer up and on their skis. But that was a nasty tumble. And even with the protection that they wear these days, that's flat on the back, right on the base of the spine, the coccyx. That's going to hurt Kasparova, and it may hurt her qualification opportunities as well. She'll pick up a single point from that. Now, in fact, she won't pick up a single point because she didn't get across the finish line. So only three scoring from that race as things stand. All three athletes looking over their shoulder for their opponent. Now, is she going to get down in time to be able to register the point? I think the officials have said to Kasparova, you've got to finish. But she's had the stuffing knocked out of her there, and that's sporting applause. That's good to see. Casas Cordero with the applause, and it is confirmed she does pick up the point. But if she walked out the side of the course and skied down, she wouldn't have got that score. That takes her to 5 points. Edebo, though, moves to 8 points with Nicoline Nielsen of Denmark on seven. Casas Cordero moves to six, so things warming up nicely. Garin Bein then of Switzerland, second fastest racer down the course, but we saw what happened to Kasparova. Guarantees you nothing by the time you get to race pace with others around you. Dana Vodka then in green for Russia, Garin Bein for Switzerland in red, Nikainen in blue for Finland, and Isabel Brown of Great Britain in the yellow bib. And trying to get into that racing tuck to get back to the group, but the two leaders, Nikainen and Garin Bein, looking solid. Got to take care of the course first and those around you second. Now into this negative turn, I think we're going to see drama there come the final stages. Over that jump, they didn't take it fast enough to get too much air. But Gantenbein here is going to pick up another 4 points. In fact, it was three she took from the first race, I think, so 4 points for her on her second run out. Leikkainen has already had a win, so she'll pick up the 3 points second time around. She'll be satisfied with that. Vodka the two, Isabel Brown having to settle for the 1 point for Great Britain. I told you these heats roll through very quickly. Organisers doing a fabulous job here to keep this all rolling. Seven. Next out for the ladies. Zoe Chaw, the Canadian. She's skied well so far today. She's in the red. And Celia Funkler of Germany in green. Zagnoli of USA in 11, wasn't happy in her first heat about some of the shenanigans from Nielsen. And Sapyanova in yellow, bringing up the rear. But this is so easy at the moment for Zoe Chaw.
Another Cranbrook qualifier from Canada. She and Reese Howden from the same area. And they've done well to make this team, but she's got company now. Oh dear, that's a little touch from the green bib of Funkler. And if anything, that's just driven Zoe Chor on. So got a bit of a boost there from Funkler. Funkler in second, Zagnoli in third. And Safionova gets the single point in fourth for Kazakhstan. Zoe Chor, the Canadian. Another score, very fast in qualifying, didn't have it all her own way in the first heat, but she's picked up the 4-point score in the second heat, and that's put her back in contention. Remember, top eight going through to the semi-final knockout phases. Confirmation of the score then. Sure with the 4, Funkler with a valuable 3, Zagnoli has to settle for another 2, and Safionova not quite there in that race. Now this will be interesting. Zaley Orford again, great start from her. We'll see whether she can keep it going. Picking up 3 points from that first race. Can the Australian put some more points in the bank? Orford in red, Reina of Austria in green, Tresal Moroz of France in blue, and Ruud of Norway in the yellow. That's really good work. Offered very aggressive once again through the rollers. She's another racer that physically can handle herself out there on the course. And we've got a faller. That looks like the blue bib of Teresa Moroz of France is not going her way today. She got nudged out of it by Nielsen in the opener. Now Teresa Moroz will have to get up and come down this course for her point. With two races to go, that could be valuable. And look at Zaley Orford go. It's impressive, and so was the drone shot as well that we got on, I think, the key part of the course. Showing the sort of speeds that these athletes are travelling at. That's a good ski from Orford. She takes the points for Australia. Reina takes the 3 points for Austria. And then Ruud still on her skis, taking the 2, and we'll wait for Tresal Moroz to come over. Well, it didn't look like too much happened there. And Reina pretty lucky actually to stay upright as well. I think that was all Teresa Moroz's problem. She caught the back end of Reina's skis and that nudged her own outside ski away just coming into that turn. Well, a DNF for Teresa Moroz. I didn't think she was injured. Looked like she was up and about. Let's hope she's okay. And no, here she comes. So the DNF might have been a bit premature. We'll see if she actually came through the valid part of the course. The jury will inform us any moment now. And a good score for Reina there, putting her into the top eight for the moment. Update you on that very shortly, but Adebo is leading for Sweden for the women with 8 points, just ahead of Orford, Nielsen on 7 respectively, and then Gantenbrand Funkler and Casas Cordero on 6. Zoe Chor and Martina Reina have got a bit of work to do still to guarantee themselves qualification. I love this round-robin system. It really works, and it also gives these young athletes the feeling that they've been involved in the heart of the competition. Had a good ski out there, had a lot of races to enjoy. David Marberg then of Sweden, the fastest qualifier. He retains that red bib, goes up against Sander for Kalman in this next one. Russell Malm in blue. For Kalman is in the green. And Kirill Bagin, who fell last time out, the Russian in yellow. Now Malm in the blue, nearest the camera. You see him getting himself psyched up. He's another very sturdy and muscular athlete. He enjoys the physicality of ski cross racing. So he's moved to this from what was originally an alpine background. And away we go. Little stumble there from Merberg in his haste to get across the rollers, but he's done it well. And that is some speed. Legs pumping, getting that drive through that section. So Merberg leads just ahead of Verkammen, the Belgian. again through that negative turn into the jump, and we've lost one, and I think we have lost Russ Malm of the USA. Yes, McCammon is still on his feet, and Kirill Bagin looks like he's still upright as well in the yellow bib. But that's a great race from David Marburg. Drives for the line, gets across it comfortably ahead of McCammon, and 3 points picked up by McCammon, 2 points by Kirill Bagin, but it's the 4 points going to David Marburg, and the B netting, the safety netting alongside this course coming into play there. Yes, it was just ahead of that turn. And Malm took a nasty one there. It's confirmed. And at the moment, a DNF, but we've seen that before. The racer has actually come down. I'm not sure Malm fancies getting up from that and finishing. He looked okay. Oh, there he is. It's good to see. See how much of the course he had left to ski. He's down. So just a slight delay before heat six. Conor Wren, the fastest man in this heat, so courtesy of his qualification. There's the red bib, Marcel Ullmeier in the green bib. Matteo Lucatelli, good win for him last time out, in the blue for France. And Mathis Boissard-Havi also picking up good points last time. Through the rollers then, into the course proper, and it is Cornel Wren of Germany that leads, just ahead of Matteo Lucatelli in the blue. And in third position at the moment, Marcel Ullmeier in the green. Just lost a little bit off that jump to Boissard-Havi in the yellow. But this is a blinding run from Cornel Wren. Wow, that's quick. Into that wonderful sweeping right-hander. And Cornel Wren is away and clear. Tucks it off the jump to the line. It's going to be another good score for the German. And the dive for the line. Matteo Lucatelli's got the bit between his teeth. That was a little bit tame from Marcel Ullmeier of Austria. Didn't really push for the line there. I think points wise he's probably ended up paying the price. Easy one to score, everyone upright and everyone across the line. So Wren picks up the four, Lucatelli three, Ullmeier taking the two, and Boissard-Havi taking that 1 point. That puts Marburg and Lucatelli at the top of the tree at the moment as we head into this next heat. Rhys Howden, the man to watch in this one in the red bib. Canadians going pretty well at the moment here in Lillehammer. And the tall Canadian, whoa, worked really hard with the legs there and cleared the table completely. Rhys Howden then tucks in front place just ahead of Rudy of Switzerland in the green. In the blue, it's Tobias Nossaisen of Italy with the Hungarian Benc Nagy. Way back in fourth, you can just hear the buzz of the drone following these guys down the course. What a brilliant view of exactly how they're racing this one. Now Rhys Howden has got company here. This could be interesting if Rudy fancies it. He might just settle for the 3 points, and he does. Doesn't push Howden at all. You can see from the celebration of Rudy, he's happy with the 3 points. For Rhys Howden though, two from two. That's a great start, and at the halfway point, that moves him to 8 points. And at the moment, the only man on eight. So Howden, Rudy, Nossaisen and Nagy. So 1, 2, 3, 4 from heat seven. Heat eight, and we really will be at the halfway point of racing in the heat stage here in the ski cross of the Lillehammer Youth Olympic Games. Louis Mullen in red, Dougie Crawford going up against his Australian compatriot in green, Roberto Negrin in blue, and Fernando Soto Herrera in yellow. Good race from the Mexican, based in Europe, first time up. And Negrin has been shoved off to the back now. So Soto Herrera in third, but it's the top two positions we're looking at. Crawford versus Mullen. Little national championship going on here for the two Aussies. And a big adjustment there from Mullen, trying to find the inside line. He's got to be careful not to take his own teammate down there. Little look over the shoulder from Crawford to say, what are you doing, mate? Come on, let's have the points. And that could have been a silly moment. Mullen gave it a go, and that's what Ski Cross Racing's about. And a quick apology there to Crawford. But it's Crawford that comes away with the win. Solid start still for Mullen. And he'll be pleased to add 3 points to his single point that he picked up in that first race. But the Aussies having an absolute duel on the way down there. That was a good heat. 4-3-2-1. Crawford, Mullen, Negrin, Soto Herrera in that order. And the Mexican racer has just missed out there. He was clearly in third and had a few problems towards the end. So that leaves Howden and Crawford, the only men on 8 points. They top the table. Top eight, remember, to get through to the semi-finals and the knockout phase. Moberg, Lucatelli and Wren all in there with Ilmar Rudi and Bossard Harvey at the moment. Is the man in eighth position on 5 points, just ahead. But Louis Mullen. So halfway stage of the heats reached in the ski cross. Pretty much the new kid on the block, only became a full Olympic sport in 2010 in Vancouver. Michael Schmidt, the first men's gold medalist. Then in 2010, it was a sport that really did capture the imagination. But interestingly, after something like 15 years as a regular fixture at the X Games dropped it back in 2013. So full marks to the IOC for adopting ski cross as part of its winter sport program. It really is, alongside snowboard cross, such an entertaining event to watch. Fans now and racers from across the world getting into this discipline. So a little pause at the halfway point as the women just get their bibs ready for the next race. So this will be heat 9 for the women. And taking her time putting the red bib on is Clara Kasparova. Good to see her in this heat, because that was a very hefty tumble she took. Came right down on the base of her spine off the jump, and she'll be taking a lot more notice on the way down here. Dana Vok of Russia in green, Abigail Zanioli in blue, Ebba Rud of Norway in yellow. That's how your colours stack up for heat 9. So ready to go. 4 points required here, and Kasparova is the athlete that needs them. So watch for an aggressive start here from the Czech Republic racer. Right out of the gate, through the rollers. Kicks it up and onto the top of the table and straight into that racing line. That's a good, tidy start from Kasparova, and nearly a fall from Zanioli, the American, but a little bit Bambi on ice for a while. Managed in the end to stand it up. In terms of the front of the race, no problems at the moment for Kasparova, showing us what she can do in terms of her speed through qualification. It's Dana Vov of Russia in second. Ebba Rud of Norway in third. And this one, as ski cross races sometimes do in the earlier phases, developing into a little more of a procession. Pretty straightforward win for Kasparova. Gets herself back on the scoring trail. Vov with a valuable 3 points. She'll take that. By Zanioli, who did very well to stay on her skis after that early mistake coming off the table. Zanioli picks up, I think, the 2 points. With Ebba Rud having to settle. Yes, the Norwegian
with a smile. Happy to settle for the single point. So into heat 10. So technically, mathematically, we're bang on halfway now. Alina Gantenbein in the red has looked very impressive today, but losing out on that occasion to Veronica Adebo, who leads the standings at the moment. And Adebo flying away and clear in the green bib. Can Gantenbein get back to her? Gantenbein very quick across the snow when she gets into that racing position, and she's taking meters out of her. So Adebo's got some company here. Now, is Gantenbein going to gamble on the inside line? No, not tight enough, not close enough to her opponent to give it a go. And that's a good effort by Gantenbein to get through, and she's done it. Adebo tried to shut the door and then comes back with a little bit of superior speed on the bottom third. Good clean race. That was a corker. Adebo tried to shut the door. Gantenbein wouldn't be budged from her line. Look at this, nice inside take, but unfortunately the Swiss just clipping the gate and just lost a bit of speed. She hit the bottom section, much cleaner. Out of that little contact was Adebo, so she picks up another four. That'll put her right in qualification zone A. 12 points for her. Gantenbein moves to 9 points. Jasan Moroz in the blue picking up five. Picking up the two. Safianova picking up the one. So they are on 5 points apiece, just outside the qualification zone at the moment. Heat 11 in the red. Zoe Chor has looked really impressive, the Canadian. Just like Reese Howden, quite a tall athlete, but makes it count. Martina Rainer of Austria in the green, with Nicolai Nielsen of Denmark in second at the moment. Nielsen has pulled a couple of good manoeuvres to score points so far. And Isabel Brown, I can't see Brown at the moment, so looks like the British athlete taking a tumble there. Zoe Chor, as comfortable as you like. Little bit heavy off that jump. Kicks it through the rollers for the finish. And a good drive for the line from Nielsen. Guarantees the 3 points. Martina Rainer has to settle for the two in the green bib. That'll make things tight. And oh, that's not a good sight. That's not a good sight, I'm afraid, for Isabel Brown. Well, the accident happening just a little bit earlier, but standing very gingerly. A knee problem there, I'm afraid, for the Brit. So comes off, goes straight into the top of the table. And I know it doesn't look like much. I know little movements like that can look innocuous, but on this icy snow, that's enough to pop a ligament in the knee. Let's hope Brown is okay. So Nielsen moves to 10 points. Zoe Chor moves to 9. And Martina Rainer on 7. It's going to be tight for Rainer as we move to our next qualifier. Sally Orford of Australia has looked really impressive, I have to say. She's in the red bib as we move into heat 12. Celia Funkler in the green. Mina Lehikoinen in the blue for Finland. And then Casas Cordero, who promised so much from the first run. The Chilean is in yellow. Making heavy work of this third heat. All good so far from Offord. Zaylee Offord. Is that heroine? Is her namesake. The Nagano Olympic slalom bronze medalist and world champion from 99, Zaylee Stegall. She's inspired so many young athletes in Australia into winter sports and snow sports in general. And it's another good, solid performance from the other Zaylee. Funkler still doing some business there in second, picking up the 3 points. We'll wait for the confirmation on the others. Lehikoinen then gets the two. Magdalena Casas Cordero. The Chilean now starting to slow down with her scoring. And that means that we can have another look at our table. Adebo still leads on 12, Offord on 11, and then Nielsen on 10. But the business end, it's Martina Reiner now, right on the bubble at 8. And we will have to see how she does in that final race to see if she can book herself a place in the top 8. As we've done all afternoon, from the ladies' side of the draw to the men's for their third round of races. David Moberg in the red, Ilmeyer in green, Norsaisen in blue, Soto Herrera in yellow. This one could be tasty. Now watch Moberg's start. The Swede in red has been very good across the rollers in the table, but he was a little bit uncertain there. But I think it's the power he's putting down that has made it look like he's a bit unstable. If he can just get that balance sorted out, then he will be unbelievable out of that section. As it is, he's just about untouchable. Moberg in the red, making his way down ahead of Marcel Ilmeyer in the green. Meanwhile, Sison is in third, and Soto Herrera, the Mexican, bringing up the rear at the moment in fourth. See how these racers get into that aerodynamic tuck as many times as possible. Drive the hands forward. Don't get caught on the back of the skis. That's a beautiful piece of work. David Moberg not even close to looking in trouble there. That really was impressive from the Swede. Marcel Ilmeyer picking up the 3 points. Tobias Norsaisen, the 2, and Soto Herrera's challenge, I'm afraid, from a Mexican point of view, is fading. Just a single point from him. Well, Moberg is going to be comfortably inside the top 8. Confirmation of those points. As we move on to Heat 10. Cornel Wren, the man to watch in the red bib in this one. It's gone well so far, the German. Let's see if Xander Verkammen or Roberto Negrin can give him a run for his money. Benz Nagy not quite in the same class, and nearly tips up on the table. So the Hungarian in fourth. But once again, Cornel Wren with a quite priceless piece of skiing through the first part of the course. The German looking very strong here. No company whatsoever. You do want to get qualification done and dusted without any issues, without any of the possibilities of taking a tumble. But it would be nice to have a couple of races where you've got some competition around you just to be able to ski through it. But that's not going to happen here for Cornel Wren. He's going to fly across the line for the 4 points. The German is in good form. Xander Verkammen picks up the 3 for Belgium in the green bib. Roberto Negrin, 2 for Chile. With Hungary, Benz Nagy picking up a single point for 4th. Keep your eye on Cornel Wren. His race developing nicely. That's another 4 points to put in the bank for the German. But Cameron will stay in touch with his 3, that's for sure. Now, Dougie Crawford produced a cracking race, didn't he, last time up against his own compatriot, Louis Muller. Now open up against Rhys Howden in the red. So Crawford in the green, Howden in the red. Watch these two go, and it's those athletes, Canada and Australia respectively, that get away in the front 2 places, with Bossel Harvey of Norway in the yellow just behind them. Russ Malm, who took a tumble in the last race, doesn't look too keen here. He's in 4th position, the American. Howden, big, rangy, framed athlete. Crawford, just that little bit more compact, but the Aussie rules player. Plays for Murray Bush Rangers back in Australia. Won't mind any of this physical stuff, and crosses the line in 2nd, just behind Rhys Howden. Rhys Howden, just like Wren, is looking very impressive. So Canada, Germany all turning in some good performances here, and Australia continuing
what is becoming a fabulous tradition, really, for Australian ski crossers. Freestyle quality is fabulous. And Crawford underlining that, but it's Howden that takes the valuable 4 points. So Howden is going to be flying through to that semi-final stage. That's when it gets interesting. You can do all this great work and end up not through if it doesn't go well for you in the semis. Louis Mullen then, Australia in red. Sasha Rudy in green. Matteo Lucatelli, who's had a win today already, in blue. And Kirill Bagin of Russia in yellow, just hasn't quite been on the pace. And the red bib of Mullen straight out in front, just ahead of the slightly coloured Italian ski suit, of French ski suit, sorry, of Matteo Lucatelli. Quite like the Czech timber shirts of the Canadians, and that's nearly a faller. He gets another bump as Lucatelli stays upright. It's Rudy that's been barged out of it. So Mullen's going to pick up the 4 points for Australia. Lucatelli's going to pick up the three if he stays upright. Oh dear, a little bit of fatigue maybe setting in, some tired legs out there. Sasha Rudy stays on his skis for the 3 points, having a little word there with the jury. Just to question what happened. Well, he caught the back of Lucatelli's skis, then he settled down again. But look at the bang that he gets there from Kirill Bagin, the Russian. Not much Bagin could do about that. That was his race line. And Rudy skied across it. There's always a little delay when you've got some bumps on the way down, but Mullen takes the four, Lucatelli three, Rudy two, and out skis Bagin to the line in the end. So Bagin just has to settle for a single point. One more round of heats to go, and one more race in this ultimate round for each racer. Now Howden on 12, Moberg on 11, Crawford on 11. And then as we move down to 8th, Verkammen is just edging out Rudy and Bossert-Harvey at the moment. Basically on a count-back system. It's going to be interesting as we head into our final group of races. One more chance then for those at the top. Well, it's a case of booking yourself the best possible spot in the semis. There's that crack there from Bagin, but did well. Actually did protect Rudy there to a certain extent, but Rudy got back with him. A little bit of a tussle from the two of them on the way down. It was the arm out from Bagin, but that cost him in the end with the butt check. Got up to finish fourth. Well, you can see the arms going out there from Bagin, but the slow-mo for me quite clearly shows that the Russian indulged in a bit of a push as they went to the jump. His arm came out. I think Rudy was completely within his rights there to ski as he skied. Don't think we'll see anything done about that by the jury. So, job nearly done for the qualifiers as we move down to heat 13 for the ladies. That's next out of the gate. Beautiful part of the world, this, around about 15 minutes north of the main conurbation of Lillehammer, up in the municipality. And Hafjell, actually the third largest ski resort in Norway. It's one of those resorts where you just feel that there's space all the time, and with the selection now of different disciplines that you can get involved in, just alpine skiing here. Range of freestyle ski and snowboard activities as well. I think we can safely say that ski cross and snowboard cross are very popular additions to the Winter Youth Olympic Games and are here to stay. Well, as always, good to see some different flags being waved. We've had Chile, we've had Mexico.
representing South America here in this ski cross event, and they've done very well. Turned in a couple of decent performances. Not sure whether they're going to make top eight, but they've certainly entertained. And that's the reach of winter sports these days. There's also a marvellous setup of academies across Europe. So a lot of skiers choosing, if they don't go to North America for their ski education, choosing to come to Europe and settle down at one of the academies, the most famous of which, of course, is the Fanny Smith Ski Academy in Megève in France. Fabulous World Cup racer in her own right, and getting involved very early with the education of young racers that want to study but also pursue their own dreams of skiing to the top level. And for these guys, top level means World Cup appearances after, of course, they've excelled here at the Youth Olympic Games. And then who knows, maybe the full Olympics after that. That's the dream, certainly a dream that's come true for a lot of previous competitors. And even though the Youth Olympic Games is still a relatively new concept, we're starting to see the fruits of the labours. So Isabel Brown, unfortunately, is injured out of this one, so she won't start. So just three racers for this 13th heat. Kasparova in red, Funkle in green, and in blue, Tressal Moroz, who's had a fair share of upsets as well in racing so far today. Good work, tidy work from Kasparova. We'll see her being a little bit more circumspect during this final heat. She had a nasty fall in heat two. And a little bit of treatment to the back, but he's up and about. And as you can see, it hasn't damaged her race form too dramatically. Funkle then in second. For Salmoroz, he's way out of it. And I think we're going to see Kasparova and Funkle here booking their places in the semi-final. It's a beautiful ski from Klára Kasparova. So Czech Republic and Germany with Celia Funkle scoring the 3 points, Kasparova scoring the four. We're going to see them through. Just a little bit of a coming together between Funkle and Tressal Moroz, but once again the French racer losing out. Has to settle for the 2 points. We'll see what difference that makes to her on the big scoreboard. Move to the close of the heats for the ladies. We'll confirm all that for you and show you exactly who is through. Top eight go to the semis. Talina Gantenbein in the red bib will be there, but Martina Reiner needs to do a bit of work here. And with Zanioli in blue and Casas Cordero in yellow around her, it's not guaranteed. So Reiner needs the 3 points desperately. Right on the bubble at the moment, the Austrian. And in third place, that won't help her. She's got to find a way past Zanioli if she can. Carrying good speed, though, to this negative turn, but can't quite dip inside to the next jump. Good protection there from Zanioli. And if anything, Martina Reiner is losing more and more speed as Gantenbein of Switzerland just flies away from the rest of the field. Been exceptional today. We could say that as well about Kasparova, but she's had a fall, remember, so she's still out with regard to the Czech Republic. And I think that is a very good sprint to the line from Martina Reiner. I think the Austrian got it just right, turned down the chance of the pass on Zanioli, who shut the door on that negative turn. But I just think Reiner went for it, and she didn't quite get there. It was a good effort, but she's had to settle for the 2 points. That may be a problem for Martina Reiner with her qualification. Zoe Chaw is through, Adebo is through. So just a solid race here for them. We'll book their semi-final places, but in terms of who they're racing against, well, Lehikoinen in the blue still needs to do just a little bit to make sure it happens. And Eberud, I think, is out of the semi-final zone. So the yellow bib of Rude drops away at the back. Zoe Chaw in that distinctive kind of lumberjack jacket that the Canadians are wearing in the freestyle races. Goes to the front, but she's got company from Lehikoinen. Adebo as well, who was leading at the end of three races.
trying to move into contention. But this just underlines Zoe Chaw's quality here. This is a very good piece of work from her. Not the fastest in qualifying by any means, but she's been quite brilliant when she's had racers around her. And Adebo and Lehikoinen dipping for the line from that angle. We can't sort it out. Maybe we'll see a slightly closer side on view to give us an idea of whether the Finn or the Swede got the photo. And a little bit lucky there, Chaw, because there's nearly a clash of skis with Lehikoinen. But Chaw, another four-pointer. Lehikoinen got the dip for the photo against Adebo. So she picks up 3 points. Adebo, I think, has done enough already, so that those 2 points won't matter. She'll be happy enough with that as we move to our final heat for the women. So in this section, that is, we've still got another race to come to bring them up to their full 20. It's what looks like a long process on paper, but it is an entertaining process to watch. And as you've noticed, it flies by and you get a really good idea of how the races are going against each other. Zelioffa then in the red has been very good for Australia, just ahead of Dana Vovk in the green. But Vovk now losing out to the Danish racer Nicoline Nielsen. Keep an eye on Nielsen because she's not averse to a gamble or two. But not gambling at the moment. Seems happy with that second place offered. Very cleverly closing the door there. And once again gets a nice tight line onto that negative turn. And offered at the moment refusing to be budged. Now the dash for the line. Nielsen quite fancies it, but offered superior body weight, just I think giving her the speed that she needed. Keep your eye on Zelie Offord because she is racing well today. And a win over Nielsen in the blue bib. That's a good scalp for her. So the Dane settling for three. Offord taking the four, and our top eight will become clearer very shortly. We'll see exactly what they've got to do in the final heat. But Offord, looks like she is going to be home and dry. Let's update you then. Eighth position, Martina Reiner hanging on in there, just ahead of Lehikoinen and Zanioli. But above them, that's a fairly healthy advantage to be taking on. Men then with their penultimate set of heats. Moberg, the man to watch in the red bib. Sasha Rudi, though, and Roberta Negrin may have other ideas. Rosser Harvey in the yellow has been racing pretty well as well. Again, Moberg with that fabulous leg pump through the rollers and the table. So far, so good from the big Swede. So he leads in the red bit. Bossen Harvey, that's a good job from the Norwegian in yellow to hang on, and goes very tight to that gate to shut the door down on Roberto Negrin. Rudi at the back. Negrin gets shoved out wide. Rudi now takes over the challenge, trying to chase Bossen Harvey down, but Moberg is away and clear. That's all going on behind him. All the shenanigans. He has not a care in the world. It's another four-pointer for the Swede, and it's a tight finish. Bossard Harvey up against Sasha Rudi, and Sasha Rudy's reaction says he thinks he's got that one. Well, that's the kind of racing we like to see on the ski cross circuit. A couple of changes in positioning, but no change with the lead. Moberg just about guaranteeing his place with that one, and that was a mighty tight finish. Wow, sort that out. Rudi, I think courtesy of just slightly longer levers, getting the call, and he does in third. Bossard Harvey has to settle for the 2 points. Negrin with the one. It's certainly kept Rudi and Bossard Harvey in the mix. Great crowds turning out to the events here in Lillehammer.
you back to fabulous games of 94. Wonderful to see these youngsters back at this Olympic venue now to compete. Olympic Games is all about that. So next heat underway. Interesting one with some serious races. I think Cornell Wren has been the pick of the bunch today in the red bib and the yellow ski suit for Germany. And it's a good effort from Dougie Crawford of Australia in the green, but he's not going to overpower the Germans. So Cornell Wren, well, almost routine for him now, isn't it? Another 4 points goes in the bank. Dougie Crawford picks up the three. And well done to Kirill Bagin. If it's confirmed, that's not a bad effort from the Russian. He's taken Nossaisen's scalp, the Italian, settling for the 1 point down in fourth. But Bagin, third for two. So Cornell Wren, that's just about booked his semi-final place. Dougie Crawford as well, I think we'll see him there. He could have something to say, actually, in the outcome of those semis when it gets a little bit tasty. Now, this is one I've been looking forward to. Rhys Howden in the red for Canada. The tall Canadian up against Xander Fakaman and Matteo Lucatelli, who will both be gunning for him here. Great work, though. Great work from Rhys Howden. And very much like the Swede Moberg, he's superb through the rollers and the table. Now into the flow of the course, the race is looking for those tuck positions. Green bib of the Cameron in second place, looking for the three-pointer. And at the moment, Lucatelli and Soto Herrera involved in a bit of a dust-up at the back. Lucatelli can't afford to be out of the points here. Two, I think, is the best he can score, but he needs it. That's an easy four-pointer for Howden, easy three-pointer for Vakaman, and in the end, a relatively straightforward two-pointer for Lucatelli, just ahead of the Mexican Fernando Soto Herrera. Oh, who will we see raising the arm come the end of today? It's a long day of racing in Lillehammer for the ski crossers. Howden picks up another four. He'll be through to the semis. I suspect Vakaman's on his way to joining him. Last of the heats then of this penultimate round. Louis Mullen in red. Marcel Ilmaier in the green. Russ Malm in the blue. Bernd Nagy in the yellow. Nagy will not feature. It's just been off race pace today, but that's another comfortable ski from the Aussie. And Mullen, remember, lost out to his compatriot Crawford when they raced against each other, and it was a heck of a race as well. Mullen gave Crawford a real shove trying to get through on the inside, and both men could have gone down, but I guess you just forget all about it when you're racing. And that's a brilliant line from Mullen. That is ski cross at its best. Superb from the Australian, because he had all sorts of pressure from Marcel Ilmaier, the Austrian. And the Austrian's not done yet. Fighting really hard off these final rollers and giving a little push to the line. Well, Ilmaier gave Mullen a couple of nudges there before trying to dive ahead of the Aussie in the red bib. And that is an interesting look across from Mullen. But that's what you like to see at the end of these races. Yes, it's real aggression out there on the course, but once you cross the line, you shake hands. And that is a brilliant piece of work from Mullen. I think he knew exactly what he was doing. Took the nudges, happy to do so, and dived for the line. And I think we'll see 4 points for the Aussie here, despite the very best efforts of Ilmaier. He just shakes his head in disappointment. But Ilmaier will settle for the 4 points. He needed them. Now let's see how that leaves us with the top eight, with one round of races to go. And we'll know exactly what these guys have got to do. We'll have a group at the top who are qualified, even if they don't finish the next run. And then we'll move down through to the bubble, as it's called in ski racing. The athletes who are right there on the line. I'll hopefully bring you that graphic in a moment. A quick look for you, and I can tell you that it is Rudy, Sasha Rudy, that is currently laying in eighth position, just ahead of Xander Fakarman. Both men on 10, so that'll be interesting. But the likes of Howden and Moorburg absolutely flying at the top, along with Cornell and Crawford. Final round of heats then for the women before we get our lineup for the semis. And in heat 17, Clara Kasparova, one fall, but the other three races have been very impressive. Martina Reiner in the green needs a result here because she's right on the bubble, along with Mina Lehikoinen. So Lehikoinen in the blue versus Reiner in the green. This could be a race for the semi-finals. Winner of this one, depending on what happens in the other races, has got the best chance of qualifying top eight. So keep an eye on the green bib of Reiner and the blue bib of Finland's Mina Lehikoinen. And it is Lehikoinen, incidentally, that won gold in Innsbruck in 2012. Have to check out whether that is her brother, Nikki. Away, not comfortably, Kasparova. She's got real attention there. Lehikoinen has posted her intentions on this race immediately. So the Finn moves into the lead, chased closely by Martina Reiner. I don't think Kasparova wants to get involved here because she's qualified, so she doesn't want to do anything silly. So she'll sit in third and take the 2 points. This is about semi-final spots. And Lehikoinen at the moment would finish with a 1 point advantage over Reiner if it stays like this, which would put her in a really good position to qualify. But Reiner determined to get back at her. Oh, this is great racing. Lehikoinen, though, superior speed across the snow, dives for the line. She'll get the call. Lehikoinen will get the 4 points. And that is going to make things tight on my reckoning. That actually puts her ahead of Reiner now. But remember, Reiner not done and dusted, because we could see some other changes with lower scoring in the other heats, so we will see. So confirmation of those points. That's a great ski from Lehikoinen. Let's see if that's been updated on the charts. Lehikoinen, yeah, does move into seventh place on 13 points then. Reiner stranded on 12, sorry. Funkler now on the bubble, so she needs a big score in her race. Heat 18 then for the women, featuring Funkler in the green bib. Gantenbein has been superb for Switzerland so far. Expect to see nothing different. That was a heavy hit for Funkler. She landed right on the coping of the table. She's okay though. And drifts into second position. Score a 3, and that would take a back pass Lehikoinen. I think that would be Reiner's day done and dusted. She'd need a miracle to get through from there. Nielsen in the blue for Denmark, and Eberud in the yellow. He's really competed in a lot of the races today. It is Nielsen in third. Gantenbein will cross the line comfortably. Funkler takes the 3. Nielsen takes the 2. Let's see if we can just bring you up to date with what that means as we move closer to a decision on this semi-final. Just a couple of heats left to go. And, in terms of position 8, Lehikoinen on 13 points. So Funkler needs to get past that. And she does. Funkler moves to 15 points. So she's in and comfortable. It's Reiner that he's dumped down into ninth position. So I'm afraid Reiner is out of it, and our semi-final lineup is just about decided now. Zoe Chaw will feature. She's been brilliant, the Canadian in the red. We can also look for the lumberjack style ski jacket as well. All Canadian
out to the front. She's really got those rollers and that table sorted now. Denevov in the green. And in the yellow, it's Casa Cordero, but I think Chris Amoroz has decided that's enough for today. Yeah, she's just wandering down the course. I don't think she's even going to make the gates. So Tres Amoroz of France is out of it. She's not going to feature in the semi-finals. Zoe Chaw, last opportunity to view this course at race pace. You can see how much it's cutting up now. You can see quite deep grooves through those turns, which is fine if you hit the right line. Chaw punches for the line, aware that Dana Vovk was with her, but that was, well, that was about 70% from Zoe Chaw, the Canadian, and still comfortable. Tres Amoroz confirmed as a DNF, so not the best finish to her Youth Olympic Games ski cross campaign. Just very quickly look at that top eight for you. Guntenbein leads, Chaw in second, Offord third, Funkler in fourth, Nielsen fifth, Adebo in sixth, Kasparova in seventh, Lehikoinen in eighth, Reiner out of it in ninth. And we have one more heat to influence that scoring. Zaylee Offord and Veronica Adebo of Sweden will be looking for the points, and it could be, well, depends how much they want to risk at this point. This could be quite a nice little dust-up between the red bib. Well, Zagnoli in blue in third. Something's happened in the gate, which means that we don't have our full complement. Edebo ahead of Offord. And Offord in trouble. Oh, nasty one. Came to grief exactly where we saw Kasparova fall earlier, the Czech Republic athlete. And Offord's made a tough stuff. Make him tough up there in the Blue Mountains, and she's on her way down, so she will get across the line. Well, my apologies, it wasn't a gate malfunction, it was Isabel Brown who's injured and not starting. So the British athlete coming to grief in her third heat. Unfortunately, we wish her well. But the green bib of Adebo crosses the line for the 4 points. I don't think Zagnoli's too bothered. There's the fall. Horrible moment in the air. There's nothing you can do to influence it. You just try and have to control the impact, and came down heavily on her hip. Let's hope that isn't a problem for Offord as we move through, because she's certainly a medal contender if she can make that big final. And for Adebo, her qualification as well, not in doubt. But for Zagnoli, will that 3 points be good enough? So last of the heat's gone for the women. And now to confirm our top eight for the semi-finals. Look for that cue next to the name for qualifying. And Lehikoinen has done it just ahead of Zagnoli by a single point. Kasparova's through. Nielsen, Funkler, Offord, Chaw, Guntenbein. All looking very good indeed. And I think we are on for some seriously good semi-final racing when it comes to the women's position later. Adebo in the end finishing as the lead qualifier on 18 points, so well done to the Swede. Those last 4 points putting her in pole position for the semis. Four more heats to come for the men, and this is another belter. I know we're still at the heat stage, but David Moberg once again, watch the Swede now, watch how he pumps the legs, but looks a little unbalanced sometimes. No, that's much more on it, and he really has nailed that beautifully through the rollers for Moberg. He comes out ahead of Dougie Crawford, who's been the bridesmaid today, hasn't he, the Australian? Apart from that one win against Mullen, his teammate. Oh, what an inside move! I spoke too soon. Crawford determined he's not going to stay there, but easily overhauled once again by Moberg. Now, will Crawford attack again? That's the problem when you take some of these risky lines. You do lose some race pace occasionally. Little swing in the air from Moberg, but he's safely down. He kept his line. He kept his composure under the sternest of pressure from the Aussie. And Dougie Crawford there with a cracking race, but couldn't quite overhaul the Swede.
brilliant inside line, but unfortunately for him, took too much pace off to make that line. A bit like Formula One racing, isn't it? And just because you've made the move on the corner and got past doesn't necessarily mean you're going to win the race. Smallberg takes the 4 points. That's his semi-final put. Crawford is booked in as well. Lucatelli and Nagy. Well, Nagy is not going to feature, but Lucatelli may still have a chance. Just have a quick check on those scores for you. Smallberg and Crawford at the top with Howden Wren. Lucatelli in fifth on 14 points. I think he might have done it. So, France and Lucatelli will be watching these next few races with interest. Cornell Wren and Sasha Rudy, along with Russ Malm, who hasn't really managed to find his form today, the American. Fernando Sotarero flattered to deceive early doors, but the Mexican, unfortunately, has now fallen away. Sotarero, one of those athletes based at the Fanny Smith Academy in Megève, France. Coached there by Guillaume Nantamot. A lot of specialist ski cross coaches out there as well nowadays, but quite a few of these athletes coached by out-and-out alpine racers, and really there in the national programmes to see whether alpine will be the way forward. But there's such a great skill set. If you remember back to Darren Ralphs, the US downhiller, who transferred his skills a few years back to ski cross, and successfully so. There's a real skill base that you can transfer across from one to the other and have a very successful ski cross career. Red bib, Germany, Cornell Wren. Green bib, Switzerland, Sasha Rudy. Then it's Russ Malm in the blue, out of the back. And Sotarera is in the mix in the yellow in third. For the moment, Cornell Wren, the big German. He is a very physical athlete. That's going to be interesting semi-final racing. He's certainly one of those ski crossers that you cannot budge off his line if he doesn't want to go. But it's like Sasha Rudy trying to move into position to see if he can budge Wren off his line. Good luck with that, young man. Solid racing though from Wren. Too much speed in the skis. Technicians have done a great job on this setup for Wren. He's looked very, very fast across the snow. Another 4-pointer for the German. A 3-pointer for Sasha Rudy. And if we go back to our overall scores, just take a quick look for you. Wren is definitely guaranteed semi-finals. And Rudy has got himself to 13 points, so that should be enough for Sasha and Switzerland to book their place in the final. Two more heats to come for the men. Heat 19 featuring Reese Rowden. Now let's take a look at how Rowden deals with these rollers. Let's take a look at whether you think he's going to be in contention come the semis. Look at that. Very, very stable. I love the way he does that table. Comes off that last roller and does like almost like a long jumper, a little hitch kick that gets him clear of the table. Hits the downslope and he picks up massive amounts of speed. That really is clever from the Canadian. So he's tracking in first place for another 4-pointer. In the yellow bib, it's Kirill Bagin. In the green bib, Marcel Illmayer, trying to hunt Reese Howden down at the moment. And in the blue, Roberto Negrin. Chile. North America controlling this one. This will be Howden through to the semi-finals. Well, that is a terrific race from Kirill Bagin, who was, well, he's had a real up and down day today. The Russian has been out of it. He's had a fall. And then he's come through against this one. But there's that fabulous bit of downslope work from Reese Howden. And if he can do that in the semis and the final, then he is definitely on for a shot at the podium. Howden moves through with a maximum score at the top of the table. Fours all the way then from Reese Howden. He's into the semi-final. And Mullen now on the bubble for Australia on 12 points. For Cameron just behind him on 10. That That's going to make this final race very interesting indeed, because both men are in it. So Mullen versus Verkammen for a place in the semi-final. Red bib of Mullen. Look for him getting a lead out of this whole shot. He's been very good through this section, and he's very good again. Verkammen in the green can't cope with him. So Mullen skiing himself into a semi-final position at the moment. Verkammen has to have a go at him at some point if he can get in touch. I suspect we'll see him dive on that inside line. Not this time. Over the jump, but here comes Verkammen setting it up. He's going to cut across the back of Mullen's skis at any minute now. There he goes. Now he's going to come back and try and slingshot through against Mullen. Mullen with a little nudge. Verkammen is a big man. The Belgian is going to carry a lot of speed to the line. And look at it. These two flying for the line. And Verkammen looks like he's going to get this one. Oh, he does. Well, that might be a real problem for Mullen. But from Verkammen's point of view, he may just have done the business. And Australia might just struggle to qualify two through. Bossard Havi and Nos Sisson, the other two racers in that group. But it was the race at the top that was so important, and that means now our heats are concluded. We've got all the scores in. And just checking down through the list. Verkammen has done himself a few favours, but Mullen has got enough points to ensure that he's in the top eight as well. So that bumps Lucatelli and Ilmeyer down a couple of spots. I think Mullen's done enough. Verkammen scores the 4 points he needed. Mullen gets the three. I thought it was going to be a problem for a moment, but he's okay. He is okay. Well, we've had a cracking day's racing so far across snowboard and ski cross. And we're now heading forward to some really exciting semi-finals. Two semi-finals to come for the ladies, two semi-finals for the men. Then we go into the small and big finals, which will follow back-to-back in each category. Big final, though, remember, the top four will be skiing for those medals. France and USA at the moment picking up the medals for the snowboard cross. Well, after qualification and then five heats, you're going to feel it, no doubt about it. So there's some tired legs down there in that finish area. There's your confirmation. Ilmeyer has made it. Rudy is the unlucky man. Lucatelli, Verkammen, Mullen, Crawford, Wren, Moberg and Howden are through. Australia with two in the top eight. They will take that. And those are the guys that unfortunately just miss out today. But you hope that they feel they've had a good group of racing there, a really good block of races to take away from this Winter Youth Olympic Games. And some of the athletes, especially from some of the smaller winter sport countries, we will see in action in other events. And the reaction the same across the world when you see yourself on the big screen or on the camera. Doesn't change, does it, from country to country, from event to event. Look, there I am. Brilliant. But no such celebrations allowed at the moment for our athletes, because they're all gathered around that board where the race results are all pinned up. Confirmation of the semi-final lineup will be coming out soon for the men. We've got it for the women. Whoa, semi-final one. Unbelievable. Veronica Edebo, Zaylee Orford, Nicolene Nielsen and Clara Kasparova. That's semi-final one for the women. That's an incredible race to look forward to. And in terms of semi-final two, well, Zoe Chor and Talina Gantenbein, I think they will feel that there's a 1-2 to be had there against Funkler and Lehikoinen. I don't think it's anywhere near as clear-cut in semi-final one. And then the coaches, the athletes, still gathered around the board where semis will be pinned or taped up. and they'll have a rough idea, seeding wise, exactly where they're going to be and who they're likely to be against. Well, who's your money on as we enter our final stages? We have got some unbelievably good races to look forward to at the semi-final stage. And for the women, maybe the pick of the bunch, that first semi-final, all four races perfectly capable of qualifying for the final and attacking the podium. But we are moving into a different phase because we're moving into knockout. And the way it works from here, top two will progress to the big final. And the bottom two will go to the small final. The best they can finish there is fifth, which would still be a very good result. But that's going to be a tough race to ski if you had your eyes focused very much on a podium place. So, men's semi-finals have just been confirmed. Let's take a look at them. Rhys Howden, Dougie Crawford, Xander Fokkaman and Matteo Lucatelli. That's a combative opener for the semis, for the men. But I think that means semi-final two for the guys is going to be the big one. Yes, it is. David Marburg, Cornell Wren, Louis Mullen and Marcel Ilmaier. Well, two favourites in each of those semi-finals, but you never know when everybody's in the mix. And if you can get your ski speed up there, be in with a shot at making a passing manoeuvre, that's when we can sometimes see the athletes fall. And that's when we get those interesting finishes. There's a medal there to be had, but it's nowhere near over and done with. It certainly isn't cut and dried. The business end of the ski cross here in Lillehammer at the 2016 Winter Youth Olympic Games. We've had a fabulous afternoon of heats racing so far, and I think we've got some potential future superstars in the offing to watch across our remaining eight races. Two semi-finals for the ladies, two semi-finals for the men, and then we move to our small and big finals. The big finals, top four from the day, top two from each of the semis qualifying through to that medal final. That's when you get a shot at gold. It's an interesting situation. It's a long, long afternoon. Months of preparation put into this. But now we get to the very tricky phase, that knockout phase where you put a ski wrong, you get an opponent ski into you, and your day could be over. That's the kind of pressure the ski crossers are under, and I sometimes think that's what helps them get over the fact that they are in what is essentially quite a tough sport, quite a dangerous sport sometimes. I do like the look of this particular course here in the Hafjell Alpine Park, but it's also got potential. There's a couple of jumps in there. We've seen two fallers today coming off the jumps. We've also seen an unfortunate, what looked like a knee injury for Great Britain's Isabel Brown. Let's hope she's okay. Looked to just take a nasty tap as she landed on the coping of the table. But in terms of the top end, in terms of the medal positions, well, we are going to have one heck of a dust up to decide our top three places. I hope these pictures on YouTube are doing what they should be doing, really. Cheering you up, entertaining. Making you fancy a go at ski cross, maybe. And failing that, maybe just a little trot down the slopes in the sun. It's a good life. But at the top of this course, it is a very nervous life at the moment for our finalists. Top eight ladies and men, if you've just joined us, through to the semi-final stages of this ski cross competition here at the Winter Youth Olympic Games. Adebo, Offord, Nielsen and Kasparova. That's your semi-final one for the ladies. I think that is the pick of the semis. That is going to be a huge race. In terms of semi-final two, Gantenbein and Chor are the clear favourites, but Funkeler and Lehikoinen could have something to say. That's your eight semi-finalists for the women. And then a little bit more clear-cut for the men. Howden and Crawford have been going well, but for Kamen is a big unit. The Belgian will be looking to get amongst it, and Lucatelli from France has caused a few problems today. He certainly doesn't back away from the challenge if there's an opportunity to pass on this very tight course. And in terms of the second semi-final for the men, well, it's Moberg of Sweden against Wren of Germany. Wonder who's going to get the whole shot from the table and the rollers. Certainly Moberg has been the man to watch today, along with Reese Howden of Canada. They have been fabulous through the first part of that course, but Mullen and Illmeyer also pretty quick there as well. So if they're in the mix, if they're contesting, then we could see a very tight second semi for the men. So we're just about ready to go. There's always a little pause while the course is checked. The athletes are given proper rest time from that final heat as we move through to semi-final one. And then once we get that running, then it will be fast and furious all the way through to the close. Well, the first semi-finalists for the women are in position. You're going to hear all sorts of weird and wonderful calls from the coaches and the fans around that area. But Veronica Adebo and Zaylee Offord have been in very good form, but you cannot count out Nielsen and Kasparova. Kasparova, remember, the fastest qualifier today from the Czech Republic. So, in the red bib, Adebo of Sweden, finishing top of the qualification. Zaylee Offord of Australia in green. Nikolai Nielsen of Denmark in blue. And the Czech Republic's Klára Kasparova, who's had one nasty fall today, but still coming through with flying colours. She is in yellow. Look for this start, though. Who's going to get the call out of the gate and through the rollers? If they can get that downslope on the table, then they're in business. It's good work so far from Adebo. Adebo pumping those legs. Hits the top of the table, though, along with Offord. And it's Offord that just gets herself into the lead. And look how hard Nielsen was having to skate. Didn't go particularly well away from the table, but she's got some speed now. Nielsen up against Adebo. Top two go through to the big final for a shot at the medals. And at the moment, Zaylee Offord is being left all on her own in that green bib. Now Adebo's starting to build some speed. Just ahead, Offord is looking good. Looking very smooth, the Australian. And the blue bib of Nielsen comes through against Adebo. And Adebo being given a real run for her money here. It's going to be Offord from Nielsen. And Adebo dives for the line, but I'm not sure she's done enough. And that's what I was saying ahead of these semi-finals about how cruel this sport can be. Adebo flying, qualified in top spot, and she's going to have to now ski the small final with fifth, the best place that she can get from this Youth Olympic Games. Nielsen, she's done it before today. She's made her move, and she timed it beautifully. And look at that desperate lunge at the end from the red bib of Adebo. Well, we have to wait to make absolutely sure of the result, because you can get a complaint, you can get the jury in, but no, it is... Well, my apologies, Offord and Funkeler there. Well, had Nielsen down on our start sheet in the blue bib. My apologies for that. We'll have to double-check that graphic as we come through. Nielsen down in the blue bib to go then in semi-final two, if that is the case. So apologies for that. But we do know that Offord is through. Second then of the ladies' semi-finals. Gantenbein in the red has been the form athlete, but Zoe Chor has once again done it quite beautifully through the rollers. And just like Reese Howden, she uses it fantastically well to get that downslope. So she's carrying the speed. Gantenbein on her tail.
in the red bib for Switzerland and tries the inside line. Ganton Bryan gets it for the first time. Zoe Chaw has got a bit of work to do here. She's a very calm skier, the Canadian, but I don't think she was expecting that kind of aggression from Ganton Bryan on the inside line. And the Swiss racer is absolutely flying now. And oh, I'm afraid from Canada's point of view that Zoe Chaw is in real trouble here. And I don't think Zoe Chaw is going to qualify. No, she's been skied out of it by Klara Kasparova. Well, fantastic work. Ganton Bryan was superb in the end. So she makes the big final. And from the point of view of Zoe Chaw, has looked so solid all day long, so good. But in the end, cannot do the business. And Ganton Bryan and Kasparova, in fact, the two fastest qualifiers from the very first race this morning, are through in top spot. A very disappointed Zoe Chaw will have to ski the small final along with, well, it is... back to confirmation of the results, semi-finals to the big final. There you go, Offord, Funkler, Ganton Bryan and Kasparova. Straight on with the action and straight into the men's semis. Rhys Howden in the red bib, Dougie Crawford in the green, Xander Fakarman in the blue. No, it's in fact Louis Mullen in the blue bib and Marcel Ilmaier in the yellow. Semi-final one then, ready to go. And Rhys Howden has been so good through the rollers and off the table. That's worked well. Louis Mullen though, the Australian, up against his compatriot in this one. So Australia with a really good chance of qualifying somebody through to the big final. And at the moment, Howden doing the job. And he doesn't look to have too much company, unlike his compatriot Zoe Chaw, who was so unfortunate to miss out in the women's semis. It is going to be Rhys Howden. Mullen in the blue, staying ahead of Dougie Crawford at the moment. So Australia will have someone in the finals. And in the yellow bib, Ilmaier crossing the line with a shake of the head. He knew he was never in that race. Dougie Crawford in the end drifting away from the back. So first semi-final, Canada, Australia. Looking like they are qualified for the big final. Ilmaier and Crawford will have to contest the small final. There's confirmation of the result, confirmation of the qualifiers. Howden and Mullen are through. As we turn our attention to semi-final two, David Marberg, who I think has been as good as Rhys Howden through the first section of this course, which is a real make or break moment. Just watch how Moberg controls this now. He's up against the big German Cornell Wren, who could cause him problems, and Xander Fakarman as well is a big unit. Lucatelli though, buzzing around everybody today and causing problems from time to time. And it's Wren Cornell who's been most impressive. Oh, and Cornell and Moberg are down. The two favorites are down, and that's a real problem. There's drama in semi-final two. And Vercammon and Lucatelli now are left in the qualification places. I don't think Cornell Wren is going to get enough speed up to really attack here. And I think Moberg is gone. And the man that has dominated proceedings today, along with Rhys Howden, David Moberg, is going to be skied out of it here. All because of that crash, that coming together with Cornell Wren. So Xander Fakarman in the blue crosses the line. He'll qualify for the final with Lucatelli. The most dramatic of circumstances means that we've lost two of the favourites for the gold medal. Cornell Wren and David Moberg amongst the fastest racers today. And this is where it went wrong. A little stumble from Moberg went sideways into Wren. And effectively, that was their race done and dusted. Horrible feeling for them. Very, very unlucky. But didn't Vercammon and Lucatelli take their chance? an unexpected progression to the big final and a shot at the medal, but that's how this sport works. There are no guarantees. Oh dear, the pain etched on the face of Ren. Vercammen and Lucatelli through, Ren and Moberg absolutely gutted. No place, I'm afraid, for them in the big final. And you'd have had money on them to win medals today, if not the gold. That is a tough call. Confirmation then, Rhys Howden, Louis Mullen, Xander Vercammen and Matteo Lucatelli is the lineup for the final. Canada, Australia, Belgium, France, and some of the big names have gone. And this gold medal still very much wide open, but I think you have to say Rhys Howden now of Canada emerges as a very strong favourite to take the title. Well, their racing isn't done, because those that have gone into the small final still have to come out and try and recover their composure to race for fifth place. I think just in the big championships, that is a very tough thing to do. Understandable if the athletes really have to push themselves to get up for that one, but it's all part of the racing schedule. It's what happens in ski cross, and part of developing as an athlete at these big championships is learning to deal with those issues. But you do have to say that is unlucky. Our semi-finals then are done and dusted. Just joined us, just to bring you up to date, it's Offord and Funkler through from the first semi-final for the women. Captain Brian and Kasparova from the second. That means we lose Nielsen and Zoe Chor. Little look at the back of Jog's head. Jog, our Youth Olympic Games mascot, who's a lynx here in Lillehammer. Competition to design him has been hosted over the last year or so, and he's gazing out across the 1994 Lillehammer symbol cut into the pine trees on the side of the mountain to signify the Olympic flame being born around the world. And there's some of the crew bringing you these fabulous pictures here this afternoon. There's one of the gizmos that brings you probably the most spectacular picture, that drone just floating above the key part of this course. And that's what the drone picture looks like, being used increasingly now in sport, but just gives you such an amazing view of the racing as it happens. You get a real idea of the line that the athletes are taking. So hopefully we'll see it incorporated when we get to the slopestyle. You can see the slopestyle course just to the left of that last picture. Slopestyle events will be live on YouTube over the course of the weekend. Oh, there's a natty crash helmet. I wonder if his hair is really like that underneath. Just waiting for our confirmation of the small and big finals for the ladies' set competition. Sometimes an injury happens that means we don't get our full complement out, but the start list is out for the men's small final. Moberg and Ren up against Ilmeyer and Crawford. You wouldn't have had that one down. It's the small final after you'd seen the racing that we've seen so far during the course of today. But in terms of the gold medal, Rhys Howden emerging as the favourite. He'll go against Louis Mullen of Australia, Xander Vercammen of Belgium, and Matteo Lucatelli of France. But Rhys Howden has seen two of his rivals, Moberg and Ren, disappear. And there is Howden, imperious in his semi-final. Never looked in trouble at all. And if he gets the kind of start that he's been getting across the rollers and then that kick, that little hitch kick that he does onto the downslope of the table, he's going to be very difficult to deal with. Fabulous pictures from the Hafjell Alpine Centre. Already hosted an Olympic Games quite a few years ago now, back in 94, but these athletes are the future. And some consolation going on there, I think, for some of the disappointed racers that haven't made it through to the final stages, or indeed the big final. Still waiting for details to be confirmed of the women's small final and big final. Big final, remember, is the medal race. And as soon as that happens, then we will be underway with the latter stages. Four more ski cross races to come for you from Lillehammer today here on YouTube. Great reaction to the coverage so far. Not just seen some great pictures, but we've seen some great racing as well. The snowboard cross was fabulous earlier today. France picking up the women's gold medal with Manon Petit. Switzerland getting the silver with Sophie Heidegger. And then Caterina Capona of Italy picking up the bronze medal. There's Jorgal mascot Lynx once again. And for the men, it was success for the USA. Jake Vedder picked up the gold. Alex Dixon for Australia. This could be a good day for Australia. Might be able to get in amongst it again with Mullen in the big final. And Seb Piotrowski for Germany picking up the bronze. That's the snowboard cross results for you as we prepare to conclude our racing for the day. Well, not everybody's upset. Glad to see some athletes there enjoying themselves at the top of the hill. That's number seven, Celia Funkler, and she should be happy. Funkler through to the big final. 17-year-old, seventh fastest in qualification this morning. Chance to enjoy more fantastic images from our ski cross racing so far. I mean, it really has been world class. So the athletes making their way to the start area once again as we prepare for the last four races of what has been a quite terrific afternoon. First up, it will be the small final for the women. That will be followed by the medal contest, the big final, the top four. From our racing and our semi-finals to this point. And then it'll move to the men's side of the competition, and after that, hopefully we'll be able to stay for the medal ceremonies to conclude our coverage for today. A sport that made its debut on the world stage in Olympic terms relatively recently. He's really arrived now, I think, and is very much part of Olympic Games culture. At the Winter Youth Olympic Games, no different. Ski cross really is one of the big tickets. So last few nervy moments before we get ready for our small final for the women. It's a very tough call to race in the small final. It's the way it is. Confirmation there. Red bib goes to Adebo. Shaw will race in green. I think that's where this one is going to be decided. And away we go. Zoe Shaw trying to get the drop. Well, just settles in behind Adebo. Kukkonen and Nielsen in there as well. But at the moment, Gable having it all her own way. Yeah, a very stylish skier, can just be a little bit awkward through some of those turns. That's where she lost out in the final, and I'm afraid we've had a couple of fallers. But this small final, fifth place, will go to Adebo, just ahead of Shaw. That's the way it happens in ski cross. We've said it time and time again. Adebo looking fantastic, Shaw looking fantastic throughout most of the day. But when push came to shove, in the end, Adebo just couldn't make it all the way to the final with Shaw. So confirmed, Adebo picks up fifth place, Zoe Shaw sixth, Nicolene Nielsen picks up seventh, Lehikoinen after that four. Having to settle for eighth position, which is no mean feat from a massive field that started today. So Gantabain in red, Offord will be in the green. That's where we're looking for these two, but let's not count out the likes of Kasparova either. She's been quite fantastic today. So Gantabain in the red at the moment, being surpassed by Offord. Offord, the Australian, has had a great day's racing. She's been very comfortable with the physical side of things, and she's going to have to indulge in some here, because once again Gantabain has got the steel on the part of course that she really seems to love. Offord trying to hang in there for that silver medal at the moment, and we've had a racer go out, I'm afraid. Gantabain then ahead of Offord. That's going to be our gold and silver, but it's the gold will go to Gantabain. Brilliant performance from the Swiss today. Australia pick up another medal, it's a silver. Just waiting to confirm that bronze medal for you. There was a crash, so you never know, but it looks like Kasparova has got it. If there is no appeal. That's a shame, we never like to see that in ski cross, but it is a reality of the sport, it's a toughie. And I think Kasparova didn't look to have caused that problem, so I think her bronze medal is going to be assured. Dear, no, that is a really unfortunate fall, and very lucky actually coming back across the course to take the rest of the athletes out with her. Congratulations though to Switzerland and to Gantabain. Was very fast at the start of the day, it's confirmed. Celia Funkler was the faller, but Kasparova, no penalty. She will pick up the bronze medal. Zali Offord picks up a fabulous silver. Australia in the medals once again. The women's racing decided. Talina Gantabain is the Youth Olympic Games ski cross champion. A toughie to call today. There was all sorts of results that could have happened, but Gantabain has been a consistent performer during the day, and she's also proved that individually fastest down the course. That was a long, long time ago now in qualification, some 3 hours ago, and we just saw Funkler skiing into the finish area, so I hope that means that she is okay. So women's racing done and dusted. Switzerland and Gantabain have the gold medal. Time now to look to the men's race, involving two athletes that really should have been in the big final, but they crashed into each other in semi-final two. Consequently missed out on a spot. So David Moberg in the red, Cornell Wren, the two athletes that crashed into each other. He'll go in green, they're next to each other again. Watch out for fireworks here. Dougie Crawford for Australia goes blue. And Marcel Illmeyer for Australia goes in the yellow. So this skiing for 5th to 8th position in the small final, which today for both Cornell Wren and David Moberg, based on how well they performed in the heats, will be, I'm afraid, scant consolation. But let's not take anything away from their performances so far today. They've been fabulous. Crawford just enjoying his time in the spotlight and in front of the camera. And bib number six. So they're just confirming that everybody's got the right bibs on and that they are in the right lanes. Nice bit of G'ing up for the Australian from his coaches. So Moberg v. Wren coming across the rollers and the table. Let's hope they don't have another collision. Moberg in the red. Does look very ungainly sometimes through that section, but if he can hit the downslope, he's got lovely speed on the skis. And in fact, Wren nudged now into third position by Marcel Illmeyer. Oh, that's a great shot from the Aussie. Crawford really working hard to get round Wren. Wren using his arms to deny the Australian, but he can't stop him. Crawford moves into third, but Moberg ahead and out on his own. The Swede skiing beautifully again in this small final. Wren it is from Illmeyer, from Crawford, but I think we're going to head for a very tight finish for the smaller numbers. It's going to be fifth place overall at the Youth Olympic Games then for David Moberg, and just getting it across the line. The blue bib of Marcel Illmeyer picks up the sixth position. Well, I just don't think that Cornell Wren was in this. I don't think his heart was in this race, and it's understandable. Absolutely distraught, he and David Moberg, after their coming together in the semi-final and crashing out of the race. Moberg could only do what he could do. That was the test put in front of him, finished fifth, and he's done that in the small final. But it's not quite where they wanted to be today, and in terms of their seeding and their performances, they probably should have made it through to this one. But a real opportunity now in the big final, handed to the guys that have made it and skied quite brilliantly. Rhys Harden then is the red-hot favourite in red. Xander Fakam and the big Belgian in green. Louis Mullen, who's good through the first part of the course, in blue. And Matteo Lucatelli, who can cause problems from France, in yellow. And away they go. Matt Howden driving hard for the table, but he's got company from Louis Mullen. The Australian Mullen takes the inside line. Rhys Harden, though, has a slight advantage with his ski speed. Beautiful tuck position from the Canadian. He moves ahead of the Australian. Into third place moves Lucatelli. And at the moment, bringing up the rear, it's the Belgian Vercamen. So Canada, Australia, France. Oh, and down goes the blue of Louis Mullen. And that leaves Rhys Harden all on his own. Canada then skiing for gold here. And Rhys Harden is going to have the easiest of finishes to take that gold medal. He crosses the line for the win. And silver medal goes to a delighted Xander Fakamen. Bided his time, waited his moment, and came through. And a faller, Louis Mullen, still carrying enough speed to get up and keep going past Lucatelli, who I think has lost a ski. Well, if he has, that's an amazing piece of freestyle ski work from the Frenchman. And it must have come off when Mullen went down. Yes, Lucatelli just got a bit sideways. The ski pinged off, the bindings released. But Mullen diving for the inside. He had to do it if he wanted gold, but just couldn't get past the big Canadian. And Rhys Harden with a quite beautiful performance. Strong from start to finish today. And North America, Canada specifically, claiming the gold medal in the men's ski cross. Well, that was another very dramatic race. The Belgian flag waving, and so it should. They have a freestyle ski medal in ski cross through Xander Fakamen. And Australia are on the podium yet again. So Louis Mullen and Zaley Offord picking up medals for Australia and keeping their fabulous tradition of freestyle ticking along very nicely indeed. But there's your winner. There is your Youth Olympic Games champion for men's ski cross, Rhys Howden of Canada. Came through a very tough qualification process in Canada. The federation there taking it very seriously in terms of who they sent out to Lillehammer. That lonesome ski of Lucarelli's will be picked up later on. A shame for the Frenchman. Well, not quite the racing to the line that we were looking for, but certainly typical ski cross. Lots of thumps and bumps on the way down. But if you can be strong, if you can stay on your skis, then you will get your hands on a medal. Oh, beautiful shot of this Hafjell area here in Oya. As I said earlier, it really is a fabulous part of the world, and we have had some fabulous racing today, no doubt about it. Athletes doing themselves a lot of favours. And once again, showcasing this great sport of ski cross very effectively indeed. It's not one of the hottest tickets at the games for no reason. It really is a fun event to watch, but it's a tough one as well. So hats off to all the competitors today for turning in a quite brilliant performance. And as we see the officials down there just setting up the medal podium, we will be staying on to see the presentation of those medals. And confirmation, Rhys Howden for Canada taking gold. Xander Verkamen for Belgium taking the silver. And Louis Mullen taking the bronze medal in the men's ski cross race. It was equally dramatic for the women as well. But in the end, Gantenbein was just too good for the rest, claiming her gold medal ahead of Zeli Offord. With Clara Kasparova managing to stay on her skis when Celia Funkler of Germany took a tumble in their big final. So she managed to claim the bronze medal. So as our day draws to a close here in Lillehammer, stay tuned for another few minutes, because up next it'll be the medal ceremonies for the ski cross men's and women.
Go with our medal ceremonies. Just give you a bit of background information on our winners today. Talina Gartenbein of Switzerland, 17 years of age. She goes to the Lishana Ski School. And our hero is the first Olympic ski cross champion, Mike Schmidt. So she will be delighted to be starting to follow in his footsteps. Set the second fastest time down the slope today at 45.76 in qualification. And she wasn't far off that when she was racing in the company of others today. So fabulous performance from her to bring the gold medal to Switzerland in the ladies' event. Then in the silver medal position was Zaley Offutt of Australia, 17 years of age. And, named after her hero, Zaley Steggall, the 1998 Nagano Olympic slalom bronze medalist for Australia and the 99 slalom world champion in Vail. She was fourth fastest down in qualification, but a fantastic performance when it came to the races proper. She was very comfortable in amongst the other athletes. And the multi-talented Offutt, under 18 Australian slalom and giant slalom champion, claims a very good silver medal here. And then finally, the fastest athlete down in qualification this morning, Klára Kasparová, did eventually manage to make the podium. The 17-year-old Czech skier from the Kometa Ski Club, 45.48 was her time. And her hero is Switzerland speed star, downhiller and Super G legend Didier Kusch. And she would have been pleased to have gone very, very quickly as well today. And crossing over to the men's side of things, well, Rhys Howden, the Canadian, 17 years of age from the Okanagan ski team in Washington State. He set the third fastest time in qualification. But, the man from Chilliwack in Canada managed to pull it together very nicely for the finals, as his heroes are Axel and Svindal of Norway and his own compatriot, Manny Osborne Paradis of Canada. And quite simply says, those guys rock at speed. Well, Rhys, you do the same, mate. Great gold medal today for him. And making the most of some accidents that happened in front of him, but controlling his races very well. A youngster, young head on the old shoulders, 16-year-old Belgian Xander Verkammen. Has had a bit of Europa Cup experience. He's actually got a 34th finish to his name in Europa Cup racing. But the Belgian junior champion, whose hero is the French ski star, ski cross star Jean-Frédéric Chapuis, did a very good job today, turning his fifth fastest qualification time into an eventual podium position and a fantastic silver medal. And then finally, last but definitely not least, 17 years of age from Australia, Louis Mullen, who is going to be on your screens quite a bit, skiing all sorts of races during the course of this Youth Olympic Games, skiing ski cross, slalom, giant slalom, super G and alpine combined. He's going to be a young man who's very, very tired come the end of this games. A man from Mount Hotham Ski Club in Victoria, whose hero is Muhammad Ali. Well, he certainly floated like a butterfly and nearly stung like a bee today, but couldn't quite bring home the big one. But bronze medal for Louis Mullen, a fantastic effort nonetheless. So that's you up to date with our six medalists that we've got from the ski cross today, as we await their arrival for the presentation of the medals here in Lillehammer.
kveit da, men likevel så blir det på en måte et rumpa gjennom da.
Ja, men jeg tror vel kanskje at de har blitt utholdt sånn for lange som også da. Ikke utholdet av IOC, liksom, dette skal være en arena for å prøve ut nye format. Ja, men nye format, sant? Hva kan funke I olympisk sammenheng? Og så bruker da Fista også som et, om en testarena for å se hvordan funker dette, rett og slett kjører. Og så da erfaringen at ja, det kan en hekke og sånn.
Ja, jeg tror faktisk at vi og det bra. Men en må ha bedre tid. Da elementet må på en måte ta vekk I Ja, fy.
Jo, men det ikke bra da, men det kommer noen lagleder, når du ferdig også, men det stikker. Ja. Det ikke liksom bare noen som har involvert noen ting, og så skal du se. Da får jeg spade og skrape.